Welcome to another naming video. We're going to go over basic functional groups today. The first four of eight that you need to learn are alcohols, ethers, aldehydes, and ketones. I'm just following your flashcards that you could have printed out. So if you want to look at those while I'm doing this, that could help. So the general formula of an alcohol is ROH, where R means the rest of the molecule. So it's like a carbon chain that has OH tagged onto the end. And these guys, their naming is the group name plus alcohol, or change the ending to all. OL. So for example, you could be asked to name this. So you'd be given a carbon chain that has a hydroxide tagged on the end. By the way, these are not bases. Bases need to dissociate in water. They are ionic, and this is not ionic. We have a covalent molecule here. All right, so anyway, we need to name this. So first you figure out the length of the chain. This is three carbons, and we know the prefix for three carbons is prop. So you could either call this propyl alcohol, so the group name is going to be the propyl, propyl, plus the word alcohol, or, which is much more common, you could call it propan, like propane, propanol. Another question could ask you to draw butanol, exclamation point, because it's commanding. Okay, so to draw butanol, well, you could try it without me if you want to pause. I'm just going to go for it. 1, 2, 3, 4. I could put the hydroxide on either end. I'm just going to put it on this end and put in my hydrogens. Now, something to note here, okay, our carbons have our four bonds. Hydrogens, other than that bond, they don't have any valence electrons. What about oxygen, though? This oxygen technically has some valence electrons on it. So if I wanted to be 100% accurate, I would include those on here. In fact, this drawing wouldn't actually work if I was going to do that. I would need to switch it up a little bit. So if you're going to be adding valence electrons and you want it to be like really accurate about it, what you would actually need to do is show it like this, with the valence electrons like that. Now, if you were turning in a test to me and you wanted to show valence electrons on here and you drew them like this, I'd be okay with that. But you might just see them drawn like this if you're given, I don't know, if you're given one of these drawings. Okay, so ethers. So these guys are very similar. For them, the general formula, it also includes oxygen. You're going to have R, O, R prime, where R prime can be the same thing as R, but it cannot be a hydrogen. In other words, it does not work if you have that. You must have carbon chains on either side of the oxygen. The naming for this one is pretty simple. You're going to have a group on either side of that oxygen. You'll have, oops, sorry, technical difficulties here. You'll have a group on the left of the oxygen and a group on the right of the oxygen. So the naming is going to be the names of the two groups. Plus the word ether at the end. So, for example, you could be given this carbon, carbon. Actually, I wanted to do this carbon, oxygen, carbon, carbon. Let's make sure I got this right. So oxygens, they tend to form two bonds, which would mean it would have valence electrons, you know, however you want to write them on there. That's a good extra little note. Oxygens only tend to form two bonds. Okay, so I could ask you, name this. So you'd say, oh, look, there's an oxygen right in the middle of a carbon chain. This is an ether. What you do is figure out what is the group on this side. So what's that one called? There's only one carbon, so that is a methyl group. Then you need to figure out the name of this group on that side. So that's two carbons, which is what? That is an ethyl group. And remember, we like to go alphabetically, so ethyl methyl. Ethyl, methyl, and then put the word ether on the end. Ethyl, methyl, ether. This name tells us we have an ether that's sandwiched between an ethyl and a methyl group. You could also be asked to draw. So how about this? Draw diethyl ether. Okay, well, you know it's an ether, which means you need an oxygen right in the middle. And you know it's got diethyl, diethyl. Di means times two. You have two ethyl groups. So ethyl means I have two carbons, so I need one, two carbons on this side, one, two carbons on this side. Get four bonds on each of those carbons. Only give oxygen two bonds because that's what it tends to form. If you're not sure why, think about how many valence electrons oxygen has. It's got six. It only needs two more electrons, so form two bonds to get those eight. Okay, draw my valence electrons on there just 'cause. Not necessary, but you might be asked to. Okay, so that's ethers. Alcohols. I already did alcohols. Ha! Just kidding. Aldehydes. So aldehydes, their general formula involves a carbon double bonded to an oxygen, with the rest of the chain going off on this end, and then a hydrogen over here. So aldehydes happen at the end of the chain. That's important because ketones are almost exactly the same. They're just not at the end of the chain. For naming, their names end in al or aldehyde. So these functional groups, these guys are giving you new suffixes, new things to add onto the end of the name. The previous video gave you things to tag onto the beginning of the name. That's the difference between these videos. Okay, so I could ask you to identify the name of this guy right here. Each carbon has four bonds. I don't want to accidentally draw more than four on there, like I did in a previous video. There. Okay, so let's name this. Well, this has three carbons, so I know that gives me the prefix of prop. And I could either call it prop and al because I have this double bonded oxygen on the last carbon, or I could call it propanaldehyde. It's a mouthful. Whoops. Okay, so you could also be asked to draw. Let's have you draw pentanel. Okay, so you'd say pentanol, pent, five carbons, two, three, four, five. Al means it has a double bonded oxygen on the last carbon. It ends there, so there's my hydrogen. I need to get four bonds on each carbon. These are all hydrogens. If the problem asks me to draw all valence electrons, then I need to show those valence electrons on oxygen, and I could have done that on here too. All right, there are aldehydes. Last one, ketones. Actually, I'm going to keep it like that for now. So ketone general formulas are, again, it's a carbon double bonded to an oxygen, but this time you have the chain continuing on either side. R, where you have R prime. So R prime could be exactly the same as R. It could be different in R. The main key thing here is that it's not hydrogen. And then for the naming, these ones have names that end in, it's not one, it's own, like ketone, own. They end in own. All right, so now that you can maybe see the difference between aldehydes and ketones, I'll scroll down a little. And let's do some examples. So how about this one? Okay, here is our drawing. So while I'm filling in my hydrogens, you figure out what this is called. Okay, in order to figure this out, you need to know how many carbons you've got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. What's the prefix for 7? Hept. And then you think, okay, well, I see a double bonded oxygen, which usually makes me think aldehyde. However, it's not on the end of the chain. So instead, it's an aldehyde's cousin, which is a ketone. So this would be hept. Heptan comes from heptane. Heptanone. Heptanone. That's kind of fun to say. You could have propanone, heptanone, butanone, hexanone, octanone. Those are ketones. All right, now let's have you draw one. You could be asked to draw butanone. Draw butanone. So you could try that without me if you pause. Okay, so now I'm going to draw it. 4, it doesn't matter where that oxygen goes as long as it's not on the end. This would be butanone. 4 carbons, double bonded oxygen somewhere not on the end. All right, there you go. That's our first video about functional groups.